been keynote speakers twice for CASPA dinner banquet and the annual conference. Ajit has 35 years of industrial experience. He was formerly CEO at Global Foundry and executive vice president of Spencer and Philips. Ajit is also active on global advocacy issues and has served on the president's committees for advanced manufacturing partnerships and the president's council of advisors on science and technology. Let's welcome Ajit for the opening remark.
Ni hao, and good afternoon. You know, on the way to driving to CASPA event, I was saying that I've been to CASPA a number of times now. I've given two keynote speakers, I was speeches. Probably I'm the only one with two keynote speeches so far, according to what information I heard.
Right.
Then I've been on many events. So I looked at CASPA acronym, Chinese American Semiconductors Professional Association. For me, it will change. I don't know the probably the best acronym, but it could be Chinese and Ajit Semi Partnership for Long Okay, again, that wasn't really that exciting for me yet. I need to be more creative on that, but I will be. Maybe by next time when I come to the event, I will have a better acronym for what CASPA stands for, which means me and you guys together. Anyway, last week, we had a great week in Silicon Valley. In San Francisco, we had Semicon West. And I tell you, if I was not going to talk about CASPA, my first message would have been $1 trillion. You know what I mean by that? $1 trillion. IC industry. Last year, we closed the IC industry with $430 billion. This year, we're going to grow about 15%. We're going to go to $500 billion by end of this year. Within the next 10 years, with 8% CAGR, we can do $1 trillion. Now, for me, the slogan of $1 trillion sounds such a great music to my ears and excitement for me and the inspiration for all of us here. I mean, I'm in this industry 40 years. And when it was $10 billion in the labs, we were doing 64 kilobit DRAM. Not megabit or gigabit, kilobit. And I remember that in the newspaper in Allentown, Pennsylvania, when we did the first megabit DRAM, there were like four pages of what a great product that Bell Lab has made, which is one megabit DRAM. And there were like pictures of every single person from Bell Labs involved in making one megabit DRAM. We were the first one who made one megabit DRAM in the world. And then there was like, this is the best thing happened since the sliced bread. Because you could put so much information on a chip now. And one megabit DRAM has become obsolete, right? Things have changed so much from the computers to mobile era. My first keynote speech here was about during the mobile era. And I talked about how smartphones gonna change our lives. That was in 2011, I think I spoke here. And even that era is behind us now. Now the new era of data is changing the lives big time. AI, everybody's talking about. $43 trillion TAM for AI. AI is intersecting with every industry in the world. And it's gonna make supply chain more effective. It's gonna solve problems. It will do things which human body cannot do it, human brain cannot do it by itself. It will help the human brain to do a lot more things with the AI engine. So the way we do things today is gonna change drastically in the next 10 years. With AI, IoT, image sensors, and of course, the cloud computing and the quantum computing, all these new disruptions which are happening is gonna change our lives so differently that the way we are talking today, it will change. Maybe on Sunday I'll say, okay, we're gonna use the VR goggles and probably stay at home and talk to you together instead of coming here all the way. So I don't know how things will change. It's going to definitely change. I do know that the whole medical world will change, the way the medical disruptions are taking place. And it's thanks to our industry. Without semiconductor, nothing could have happened. So we're sitting at Intel's auditorium here, and Gordon Moore's the Moore's law of doubling the transistor, people have been saying it's reached its end. I don't really define Moore's law the way Moore's law has been defined by many people. I define it by the way the number of disruptions that it will create. If there was no cost reduction and no packing density or vertical integration and horizontal integration of devices or functions, we would have never come to the number of disruptions we have today. So the way I look at the Moore's law is how many more disruptions we're going to create, and that will change the societal life. It will help the GDP. It will grow the economy. That's really the Moore's law. I think we underestimate, probably Gordon Moore himself underestimated what he said. I mean, it meant a lot. For me, I tell you, this was my own thinking for the last couple of years or so, at least, that how AI is going to transform the world and grow this industry to $1 trillion. At Second Best, we had a bunch of keynote speeches. The first keynote speech was John Kelly from IBM. And he said something which I will repeat here, and that's really my own remark for now. He said, he himself has been in the industry 4 decades. He said, I've never felt so excited. I wish I was starting in the industry now. And I think that's a very telling statement by him. Because why I'm telling you this statement, because just 5 years ago, we used to think this industry has matured, maybe single digit growth, and that's about it. And all wrong. I think it's going to be high single digit or low double digit without the memory prices. The real growth of this industry is going to happen. Because the theme of the today's CASPA is probably the primary fuel for the growth of the industry. And it's going to continue for a number of years. So I think this time has come for us. Now, there are only three messages I want to leave you with. The growth is guaranteed. I can assure you that. And being a semi head now, I get to meet a lot of executives around the world. But there are few areas that we need to focus on. Otherwise, we'll not be able to capture this guaranteed growth. This growth guarantee will disappear. Number one is the talent shortage in this industry. Not only in US, around the world. China, Taiwan, Korea, Japan, everywhere. Europe. I've been to all countries, and with my involvement as a global part of the global advocacy, I meet a lot of governments. Problem everywhere. And the root cause is that our kids try not to go to STEM education. Now, in Asia, still STEM education is much more focused. But outside Asia, STEM education is going downhill. We used to be 20% of the students used to go STEM education until the last decade, until the last millennium. Now it's 11%. So SEMI has started a very comprehensive program on the workforce development. I would like you to really speak with Long. Long is our SEMI president of China. He's basically my right-hand man also. And globally, we are driving this workforce development. Come to SEMI, talk to us, and see how you can play the role to solve this problem, both domestically here and globally in Taiwan, China, and other parts of the world. That's really number one. Number two problem we have is the investment in hardware. Most of the investment has been going to social media. Now, lately, some investment has picked up, but I can tell you the scale. Last 18 months, the investment in hardware has been equal to the 18 years prior to that. That means for 18 years prior to the last 18 months, there was almost zero investment in hardware. Now the world has recognized and realized that just investing in software will not work unless we have new hardware. Now with AI and IoT, a lot of new hardware is coming up. We need a lot more investment. So in your sphere of influence, inspire the VCs, inspire the corporates that they need to together collectively solve this problem and start investing more in hardware. Otherwise, $1 trillion may not happen. Otherwise, the changes in lifestyle in the societal which we are expecting will not happen, because the changes in lifestyle means the better medical health, better environmental situation, better agriculture products means to solve world hunger. So we need to inspire more investment in hardware. And the last but not the least, there are a lot of young people here. A lot of speakers are very young. I have been retired a couple of times. So my job and my role is I'm really giving back to the industry. So by working on a semi. So I'm right now living to work instead of working to live. But my message to you is that inspire the young leaders that their job is to focus more on innovation and help grow this industry, which will further improve our societal benefits as well as the economy. So I think that's the three messages I'd like to leave you with. And with that, I will say I have some other commitments, so I'm going to leave from this after my opening remarks, maybe 4 or 5 minutes here. And hopefully I'll see you sometime next, somewhere next time. Thank you very much.